representative students from across grade levels. The students we're honoring here tonight are our top 20 students from grades 9, 10, and 11, as well as students from two of our student leadership teams, our Blueprint Club and our student government. All of the students we're celebrating here tonight enhanced our school, and I am so happy to be able to applaud their achievements tonight, as we all are. Thank you all for coming.
But before I do that, I'll tell you what each of them are going to get. They'll get a certificate honoring the achievement. And for the first time ever, they're also going to be getting certificates of a citation from the City Council, from Vincent Gentile. So each student is going to be getting a citation, which apparently I'm sure that Ms. Shepard's going to explain it even better, that they have a citation with the city now. So their names are being recognized. It's a really exciting. You'll be getting one of these special and cherished little yellow jacket pins that we hope you wear with pride and that show that you earned one of those incredible grade points. Okay? So we're going to start with our ninth graders, and I'm going to call up to present those awards grade advisors Denise Basso and Alyssa Rafter, and guidance counselors Jeanette Martinez and Yvonne Mayer. Start off with Celia Carini. Thank you. Montague and Alyssa Zachary.
Thank you. Aya Ignite.
Thank you.
them to help us give out the certificates because we don't want to pull out everybody's name.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
also, before we get off the stage, we also want to acknowledge some staff members that have been absolutely awesome. I have to tell you, besides Ms. Shepard becoming principal, before she did that, she was our AP of organization. Absolutely awesome, us as and helping us organize. And we were just a little bit nervous when Mr. DeMartini took over. Because, rightfully so, because we were like, oh my God, we have to train someone new to adapt to us. But he has been absolutely amazing. And we want to acknowledge and thank him.
Thank you.
trinket of appreciation to Nellie and Alma Bank. She just out of the blue called me and said, hey, I want to do a partnership with your high school. And she did. She came back with the school leadership team, and she very generously gave us a scholarship and also gave some donation to the sports team with nothing given back. She just said, hey, I just want to help the school. And she did, and we really do appreciate it from the bottom of our heart. We look forward to having a continued partnership with them and in the future. So we thank you. There's something for you. And we did give a book to The Giving Tree, The Gift That Can Tell You.
Patient with us for just a moment as we clear the stage and get ready for the cast of Guys and Dogs to take the stage. I'd like to introduce you so
hi, it's your team. Wow, that was really loud. Hi. You're in for a really good show. The kids are going to come on stage. They are gangsters. They are gamblers. They are strippers. And they are in need of some reviving. You are here now for a spiritual revival, ladies and gentlemen. Please welcome them to the stage.
Now that I'm here, recognize Lee Johns.
Get up, Big Fat Water Buffalo! Oh!
You know, they happen to be kind of funny, actually. Like a dream. That's it. A dream. I dreamed last night I got a boat to heaven, and by some chance I have brought my dice along. And there I stood, and I hollered someone thank me. But the passengers, they knew right from wrong. For the people lost and sit down, sit down. I sailed away on that little boat to heaven, and by some chance found a bottle in my bed. Which is shut up.
Almost 100 students involved in the show this year. And I just want to recognize Mr. Adelizzi and we're coming to the final section of recognition of hard work and celebration of hard work. And at this point, much to the protest of our principal, we've arranged a ceremony and a way to recognize the appointment of Jennifer Shepard as our principal. So I would like to introduce first Ms. Mendick, our VP of guidance, to front.
Tonight, we are also celebrating Janet Shepard's installation as principal, a celebration that has been a long time coming, both because she assumed the role of principal over a year ago, and because her ideas and hard work have influenced and shaped our community for as many years as she has worked in this building. Every day I see evidence of how she's making our community better, and every day I'm grateful for the ways in which she makes me better, both professionally and personally. Janet is my most loyal friend. I know that she has my back no matter what. I know that when she tells my children that she loves them, she really means it. I also know she expects a lot from me, and she will never simply tell me what I want to hear. Instead, she challenges me and pushes me. She forces me to be honest with myself even when I would rather not be. All the while, though, I know she's on my side, even if it might momentarily seem like she's on my husband's side or my sister's side. In these ways, Janet is more like family to me than anything else. And of course, she and her friendship are special to me, and I hope that I and mine are to her. But what I realize makes us, this staff, our students, and their families, so lucky to have Janet as our principal is the fact that she treats all of us like family. She's fully committed to each of us as individuals and as a group. I imagine most staff members here, and many of the students, can point to a time or place that Janet treated them more like a family member than a colleague. Never for the glory, always because it was the right thing to do. On so many occasions, I've watched her run, literally run. And for those of you who aren't deans and might not know this, she is super fast. And she runs to the aid of a student or a staff member in need, to car accidents, to sick children, you name it, she is there. She's gone to the hospital, to the precinct, driven other people's cars, and called for car service to be sure that we are all okay. A few years ago, she took over all my professional responsibilities so I could stay at home when my son Leo was born and I never even had to ask. And not in my speech, but seeing Janine with her baby up on the stage, she did let me bring my youngest to school when she was first born too. And she never stops thinking about us, and really never, and I know this because she texts me a lot. She's always thinking about ways to be better for this community as a whole. Signs of this are everywhere. In the ninth grade initiative that she spearheaded and that has become a cornerstone of the work we do here. In the literacy program that she, along with a few others, brought to our students and through which so many of us learned to be stronger teachers. In the classrooms of our teachers who she taught when they were students here, and who she mentored when they began their careers here. In the expansion of the college office space, in our school's relatively easy transition to the Common Core, in the smart boards and iPads that are in our classrooms, in the academic interventions of the intensive bridge program, and I could really go on and on. But I'll only list one more thing here, and it is one of my favorite contributions, as many of you know. It's the transfer of leadership ceremony at graduation. Many of you will see that shortly. And you guys know what I'm talking about, flags forward, flags retreat. These are just some of the ways in which she has helped us all to grow. I think what Janet expects from us in return is that we are good to each other and that we do right by each other, that we make the world better for each other. My grandmother likened family to the five fingers on a hand, each with their own value, strong when we work together. We're all responsible to each other. We, as educators, have to do the best that we can for our students, always. And when that doesn't work, we can't just be satisfied that we tried hard. We have to do something different and something more, even when we're tired. You, as students, have to recognize the power you have to make good choices for yourselves, for your families that raised you to do so,
and for the people whose decisions those decisions influence and affect. And Janet really believes we can do it. She won't hear otherwise. She won't hear that we can't possibly meet with that many students individually in that little time, or that they can't possibly pass those Regents exams. She believes in all of us, and her belief gives us strength. And that way, she may be more like a Jedi Master than anything else.
Star Wars.
I sit with her in a lot of conferences and hear her say often, in the words of Yoda, "Do or do not, there is no try." And so, Janet, I have a little gift for you, something to make your office more yours.
Janet is part of a group of beloved teachers at Helen, whom I would never be as good at, but could aspire to be almost as good as if I worked really hard. Students loved her. She had a 4-star rating on ratemyteacher.com. Janet was also one of the first people in the building to be really, truly kind to me and make me feel like I was a part of the Helen community. I started working here when I was only 22. And it was really daunting to be around these teachers that all really knew what they were talking about. And Janet always made sure I felt included and took me in. As senior advisor, Janet planned the senior trip, senior award night, and graduation for all our seniors. She literally designed and brought our students to the benchmarks that would signify the ends of their high school careers and moving on to adult life. When Janet became the mentor for new teachers, it just made sense. She had a way of taking someone new to teaching and helping them improve at their craft through a process of kind supportiveness, honest constructive criticism, and visiting other teachers' classes to learn best practices. This is the point in my career where I began to feel like a leader in the school. Janet chose to bring new teachers to visit my class on a regular basis, and I grew confidence in this way. Janet took a lot of new teachers and helped them develop. When she became APO, I was very happy to take her job as mentor. Thank you, Janet. Later, Janet would become our assistant principal of organization, and when I was sick and no one could come get me, Janet took it upon herself to drive me home. There were always children in her office that had been headed the wrong way when she found them, and so she brought them to her office to try to encourage them to change their perspective on whatever situation, person, or feeling had caused them to go astray. The idea that the task of the leader is to get his people from where they are to where they have not been was once stated by Henry Kissinger. And here we are, Janet's people. And we know where she has been for the last 16 years. And so the question becomes, where is Janet taking us? Where have we not been? As principal so far, Janet took us all somewhere a little different. Somewhere that cherishes the rich past of our school and enriches it with the ideas of our young people at the forefront of how we work and live as a successful community. I took great pleasure in working with her and our student body this year, and Janet, I simply can't wait to see where you will take us now. Thank you.
We have one other speaker that he's invited to speak on behalf of the student body. Her name is Jamie Levick.
Hey guys.
on behalf of Ms. Shepard tonight. I can say that Ms. Shepard and I go way back. Like, freshman year back. Where I was just a few inches shorter and she had this like edgy sort of look going on with her hair, where it was a few inches shorter as well. Long story short, certainly things have changed. I have grown and developed into someone I wouldn't be today if it wasn't for Ms. Shepard's consistent motivation. Every year throughout my 4 years in television held some sort of an unpredictable occurrence for me that when the time came to alleviate the situation, Ms. Shepard has not only handled each one of them with such a calm and welcoming attitude, but she made sure that I was genuinely okay, all while getting her job done. Let's take, for example, that time when my mom frantically came to the school in tears and all, because someone, to this very day, I still don't know who, prank called my house and told her that they had me for hostage. All while I was just, you know, chilling in my eighth period biochemistry class. This was the first time I met Ms. Shepard. She, with such poise, was the one that pulled me out of class, and I remember the first thing she asked me was, "How are you today, huh?" All while my mom was in the other room freaking out. If that isn't what you call handling a situation with patience and ease, I wouldn't know what else to call it. Ms. Shepard has proven to me and the rest of my fellow classmates that with hard work comes success. This year, the Student Government Organization and I worked extremely hard to make projects like Telly's first ever sing-off and the senior class trip to Six Flags, also a first, happen. Ms. Shepard willingly discussed these ideas in a professional manner and treated each and every one of us as if we were no different than a member of the Tele staff. It is clear that she puts the power in principle, as stated by my local friend Dennis, all while keeping a balance and ensuring a professional career. Ms. Shepard also played a significant role in making me realize that I am capable of achieving more than what I ever saw possible. I remember having a conversation with her last year, telling her that I seriously had no idea what I was going to do when it came to applying for college, for the simple fact that I thought I wasn't good enough. Here I am today, proud to say that with the encouragement of Ms. Shepard, I will be attending Cornell University in the fall. We know what we are, but know not what we may be. Ms. Shepard, thank you for every lesson that has come out of my experiences with you these past 4 years, as I am sure that I am not the only student who had this impact on.
Special presentation for you tonight, and I'm going to have to ask the staff members and parents on stage to once again leave the stage. I'll give a special presentation, a slideshow created by our librarian and media specialist, Mr. William Daniel. Please enjoy. Thank you.
Because the past is just a goodbye.
I'm also glad to hear that, in defiance of Janet's wishes, you're honoring her as being appointed our school principal. I think it's a smart thing to do, and it's well deserved. The more I walk through schools throughout our city, the more I see how hard it is for someone to be a principal in New York City today. The kind of fortitude it takes, the kind of hard work, the kind of vision. Janet has those things, and I have known that she had those things from the moment I met her. Janet was a student teacher in my classroom in 1998. The second day that we worked together, she came to me with a series of lesson plans and said, "I know I'm not allowed to teach, but what do you think of these?" I looked at the plans. They were very well formed and they were very thoughtful. I stepped back and said, "You want a shot at teaching these plans? You go ahead." And she did. And she did beautifully and has done so ever since. I couldn't be happier and prouder that she's our school's principal, and I wish I could be there with you all today to celebrate. Thank you so much.
I feel so happy, and I can't express my gratitude to the people that organized this, even though I didn't want it, and not because I didn't think it was nice, but because everybody in this room works as hard, as long as I do, and I didn't think that I should have a special day. But that being said, it warms me and it makes me very happy. And it's the best part of this evening, and the reason that I agreed to it in the end, is because I was allowed to share it with the students, with our kids. And so because it was a celebration that we could enjoy together, I said, yeah, that sounds good. And I'm able to share our kids' wonderful achievements with my family. And that makes me feel very proud. It's my family's here. It's this connection between different people and different lives, the crossing of paths that drew me to education in the first place, believing and knowing that we are all responsible for each other. And these values and these views of the world were instilled in me by my parents, like your values were by yours. And my parents came to the United States in 1969, and they found work, and they worked hard. And they worked to better us, me, my brother, my sister. They wanted us to struggle less than they did, to carve options out for ourselves into the world. And so they focused on education, perpetually learn and grow. Perpetually learn and grow. And they gave me a sense of responsibility to family, to them, and to my community around me. And so, moving forward as we do, I apply these values to everything I do. In making my deepest friendships, my baby's gone. And in meeting and marrying my husband, forming a relationship that contributed to the weaving and interweaving of learning, of becoming better and being better for others. These are the values that Brooke and I try to pass on to my boy Mason. Accountability to the world. Accountability to the world around you. And when I bring Mason to Telly for the different events that the students and the staff host, like he's here now, I am so proud at the excitement he feels as he watches. So if it's basketball, he says, I want to play with this team. If it's the SGO that hosted an event, he says, Mommy, when I grow up, I'm going to be part of the Telly SGO. And I know that tonight, after this wonderful celebration, that he will say to me, Mom, I'm going to be part of the top 20. So thank you. And it warms my heart to hear Mason talk about Telly students in this way, because he recognizes your wonderful character. The sense of responsibility to the world around you that you have, and you all become his role models. I firmly believe in the roundness of the world, the circle that brings us all back to one another. This year, for example, I met a former graduate from 2007 who works at Mason School. And this young man, who I taught a long time ago, he's a para at the school, paraprofessional. He's a member of the custodial staff and a counselor at the after-school program that my son attends. And he watches over my boy every day. And he teaches my boy every day, and he plays with my boy every day. A boy that I once taught. These are the experiences that occur over and over, affirming for me that the kindness and academic support and challenges that we give our kids here and at home touch our lives again and again, directly and indirectly. When I graduated from college and I sought out into the world, wondering what I wanted to do, looking for a place that felt and that was interconnected, I knew I found it when I walked into this school, when I walked into Kelly. The entire HSTAT community shares these values, this responsibility to one another. Our parents, our kids, our students, our colleagues, our friends. Our parents who sow great magic here, from scholarships to organizing community service activities for our children. Our college office, who have empowered students to be college experts to support their peers. Members of our staff, who have organized peer mentoring, peer tutoring, and student-led orientation activities for our newest students. Our guidance and dean's offices, who lead students through self-inquiry with the expectation that our kids can see their effect on the world. Our cafeteria staff, who ensures that our students are fed. Our custodial team, who keeps our building looking new and holds the building to the same expectation that we hold the people within it. Our school aides, who take care of everything and everyone with pride. Our security staff, who ushers our students to their classes by name and with kindness. Our theater program directors, and show you just saw, who hold our students accountable to the high standards of performance, both in the classroom and through their extracurricular activities. Our grade teams, who work tirelessly to lift all our students' achievement. The many staff who run a wide array of clubs to give our kids, to give our students, multiple layers of knowledge. Our secretarial staff, Kitty, Kathy, Celia, Pat, Tina, Andy, Janet, Stella. They hold us all on their shoulders. Our APs of instruction, Viv, Janine, by the way, who has also been appointed. Viv, Janine, Najim, and Jeffrey support the learning of all our students and our teachers. And our administrative team, Christina and Dave, who pull all these pieces together. Every member of this community recognizes that we are part of an intricate web, every person in this community. And that's part of the reason why I didn't want the celebration. Because to be principal of the High School of Telecommunication, Arts, and Technology is a gift. It is a gift. And so thank you. And I am proud of all of our young people here tonight who have shown great leadership skills. Thank you.
I just walked away from it. I acted like it didn't belong to me. But it followed me.
I worried what others would think. What would people say about my idea? I kept it to myself. I hid it away and didn't talk about it. I tried to act like everything was the same as it was before my idea showed up. But there was something magical about my idea. I had to admit, I felt better and happier when it was around. It wanted food, it wanted to play. Actually, it wanted a lot of attention. It grew bigger and we became friends. I showed it to other people, even though I was afraid of what they would say. I was afraid that if people saw it, they would laugh at it. I was afraid they would think it was silly, and many of them did. They said it was no good. They said it was too weird. They said it was a waste of time and that it would never become anything. At first, I believed them. I actually thought about giving up on my idea. I almost listened to them. But then I realized, what do they really know? This is my idea, I thought. No one knows it like I do, and it's okay if it's different and weird and maybe a little crazy. I decided to protect it, to care for it. I fed it with food, I worked with it, I played with it, but most of all, I gave it my attention. My idea grew and grew, and so did my love for it. I built it a new house, one with an open roof, where I could look up at the stars, a place where it would be safe to dream. I liked being with my idea. It made me feel more alive, like I could do anything. It encouraged me to dream big, and to then to think bigger. It shared my secrets with me. It showed me how to walk on my hands, because it is good to have the ability to see things differently. I couldn't imagine my life without it. Then one day something amazing happened. My idea changed right before my very eyes. It spread its wings, took flight, and burst into the sky. I don't know how to describe it, but it went from being here to being everywhere. It just wasn't a part of me anymore. It was now a part of everything. And then I realized what you do with an idea, you change the world. And I want to thank you for always showing us, not just the students, the parents, and the teachers, that ideas do change the world and making this a safe haven for us to have those ideas and encouraging us to change the world.
You need more than others think is practical, and expect more than others think is possible.
Hard, difficult questions. You're never sure. You know.
Thank you all, those of you who participated, those of you for coming to celebrate the great work of our students and staff and parents. I hope you'll join us for some refreshments afterward. Thank you very much, and congratulations, students.